And the Bible code can't be a prophecy because there's too many, there's five routes. You know, if we go down road A, then B is going to happen as a result.
Right.
But if we choose to go down road C, then D is going to happen as a result. So there's you know, as we do things with free will and free choice, you know, the results that happen are because based on our actions. So there's at least five different routes at any one time that mankind can go down.
And all of this is recorded by God in His book.
Yes. And so if He so chooses, if He sees us heading in a particular direction, and He doesn't want us to go down that way,
right.
He will have His people expose their plans. Because once their plans are exposed, they'll cancel them or delay them. You know, they'll totally cancel them. I've seen it plenty of times when I've posted a code, and they just totally, you know, you could see in the code they were aggravated, they were mad, they were angry, and they canceled their plans.
Do you think that some of the governments of the world, such as the United States government, Britain, Israel, are following the Bible code and trying to use the Bible code for insight? Or
they're on my side. They're on my side daily.
So really, God can lead the nations of the world to using the code where He wants them to go.
They are very much so into the Bible code, although publicly they will denounce it and reject it.
Right.
But Michael Drosnin, look who's signing his paycheck. The Pentagon.
Oh, that would make sense, because if you read his prophecies, they certainly line up with what the government seems to want people to hear.
Yeah, and you know what? This guy doesn't have a bit of discernment. The Lord won't even let me read his material. And I've had some people, you know, heard from people who have, that it's a total waste of time. His codes are bogus. They're bad. And I'm just the kind of person that I don't trust anybody's codes but my own.
Well, that's how it should be. And at least, you know, in Drosnin's second book, he does not say, anyone out there listening who reads Bible code books or Drosnin's book, in his second book, The Bible Code 2, he does not give any location or text where his codes come from.
And see, that's what I heard.
Right, he doesn't say what program he uses.
And see, my problem with the book that I have coming out in January, where I do give information where it's found and the terms that were found together, I can't show the graphics.
But you can at least give a location.
Yeah, exactly. Now I'm thinking in the second edition, I'll be able to, because they want like $125 for every five graphics you put in the book, and I can't afford it.
But you are putting the locations. See, Drosnin doesn't do that.
Oh, yeah, they can go to the locations and check. And people have gotten Bible code programs just to prove my code's wrong, and I've never heard from them again.
Well, because they can. So Drosnin even goes as far as to fabricate codes using words that aren't even Hebrew, because if you read it backwards, it'll say something completely different. So his findings are encoded, but the words are not what he says if you read it.
Yeah. Well, you know, I post my code. You've come to my site. I post them fully. I don't show all of my work, because if you're going to do an accurate code, you have got to go through at least 8,000 to 10,000 words that are associated with that main term you're looking for.
Right. So we would say the Bible code is the future encoded in a series of possibilities and predictions, not a thus says the Lord like the Bible text.
Right. And you know what I tell people? It's like believing a decoder. One who decodes the Bible is the same thing as choosing a pastor to listen to. It really is.
That's always a mistake.
You have to listen. You have to know. I mean, half of these people online that have code sites aren't even believers in Yahweh. They do it out of self-interest. So are Christians going to go to those decoders and believe what they have decoded in God's Word?
Well, most churches, that's true, Sherry. Most churches today, I found by listening to the people that they come out of their churches, like church puppets, these people, if they're told the Bible codes of the devil, right away they say the Bible codes of the devil. No matter what you tell them, the Bible codes of the devil.
Well, they don't want the truth on anything.
No, they don't.
I was getting emails last week of a lady who was asking me about the whole Genesis 6 situation, because her pastor totally denied it. You know, oh, that's just believers mixing with unbelievers, and you know.
Well, Genesis 6. That's the passage in Scripture that makes most pastors squirm behind the...
It does, and I told her that was a typical brush-off answer he gave you, because he can't answer it, because they don't know how.
There isn't an answer, because if they say the sons of God mated with human women, if they say the sons of God are angels, we know angels are spirits and can't mate. Correct?
It blows that theory out of the water, because
right. They
can. Some of them can.
That's exactly right. And if they say that the sons of God were Adam's children, men... Well, men can't mate with women and produce mutant giant offspring. So it had, the Nephilim had to be from another planet, another world. And that's something, extraterrestrials, Bible code, anything that's outside of the box, the Christian world labels you of the devil.
Or they just say, you don't need to know that.
Right, I got an email. I told them. I got an email today. Somebody said, why are you doing a radio show with Jezebel? I mean, they had that nerve to call you Jezebel, which is pretty nasty. But
I've heard it all. I got an email this week claiming I was CIA, but if I wasn't, God bless me. You know, you get these two-sided emails where they accuse you of being Satan himself, and then at the very end, well, if you're really not, and you really are God, God bless you.
Well, right, untrue. You know, if we know Satan is working towards a one-world government, and we know that from prophecy.
Yeah.
So if you're not for a one-world government, how can you be for Satan?
Yeah.
These people, you know, churches don't teach people to think. They just have brainwashed people over the years. They tell them once saved, always saved is true. You're guaranteed heaven. And they just believe it. And anything that contradicts it, they don't even want to look at it.
You have something on your site. Let me give the phone number out again here real quick.
Sure.
For the listener calls, and if you want to ask me or Pastor Harry a question, you can call in at 260-356-2611. John in Indiana, I hope you're listening tonight. Where's my phone call, John? Okay. Pastor Harry,
yes.
You have on your site, you say, you claim, if the Bible is false, the Baptists are taken.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Well, what is that? What's that about?
Well,
I was Baptist for 30 years, you know.
Well, what I say on my site, well, by the way, that's the title of my new book, Satan's Rapture, What If the Baptists Are Taken? See, the Baptists believe a different religion than the Bible. They basically believe that if you come to Jesus or say the sinner's prayer, they believe you're guaranteed heaven and a rapture in the air.
Yeah.
They promise you heaven and a rapture guaranteed.
Eternal life. Eternal life. Just saying it's 30-second prayer.
30-second prayer and a guaranteed rapture in the air. And so what I say is, so they're really saying you can commit adultery, you can be selling drugs, you can commit every sin in the world, but if you said that prayer 10 years ago, you're going to be raptured into heaven in any minute.
And if you have a story to where you almost died and there were bad spirits, demons there to take you to hell, then they'll just say, oh, you weren't really saved.
Right. Exactly. So I'm saying, if one day 50 million Baptists and Assembly of God and Pentecostal and people that all follow this one saved, guaranteed rapture doctrine, if they're all raptured up into heaven one day, quote, raptured into heaven, then the Bible's false and a lie because everything that they believe, Jesus spoke against. You know, Jesus has about 50 warnings for the end times to watch and be ready, to be doing his will, to not be lukewarm, and it goes on and on and on. So if one day the Baptists are raptured, the Bible to me is a total lie. I'll just light a fire and throw it in and that's the end of it. But
because you realize how narrow this gate is, because
yes.
Those that are his are the ones who are actively seeking him. And doesn't he say, my sheep hear my voice, and
sure.
They know me. And how many people today can say that they can recognize when God is speaking to them?
Sure. Well, that's very true, Sherry. And that verse you just said in John 27 is 10:27. It's a critical verse because, repeat it again, Jesus said, my sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me.
Yeah, and you know how they do that?
Right.
Because they're walking with them every day.
Right, well, what the Baptists do, they delete that verse. They worship a fragment. They worship the next verse. And then Jesus said, and these will never be plucked from my Father's hand.
Sure.
So they throw out following Jesus, and they just say, we'll never be plucked from the Father's hand.
Yes,
we can do whatever we want, and we'll never be plucked from the Father's hand. And if you're out there tonight and you're listening to this and you've been brought up Baptist or these Pentecostal Assembly of God, read the Bible for yourself. Don't believe me. Don't believe your pastor. Don't believe Sherry. Read the Bible for yourself and you'll see the truth.
Steve, you got a caller?
Yes, you have John from Indiana, cute.
Welcome, John.
Well, good evening. How are you tonight?
Good, how are you?
Oh, excellent.
I didn't get a phone call last week. Everybody was asking me, where's John?
Oh, well, I wasn't able to listen, but I did catch it on the rebroadcast.
Okay.
And,
hello, John.
Hello. Hello. I can't tell you how much I appreciate your explanations on how to read and interpret a code as various possibilities. I think it was very clear and concise. I also had a sort of an amusing comment for you. I've told quite a few people about your show, and had them listen to it, and it really shows where people are at. They either love it or they hate it.
Yeah, that's how it is. You like me or totally hate me.
I've had people virtually stop talking to me because they listen to. I've asked them to listen to your show, and others who are amazed. they see the insight, they see the truth, and they're extremely pleased. So it's